Jambo Jambo, welcome on our third episode of our guided walk up here in the northern part of the Serengeti, and this is Stephen all the way from Lemala Kuri Hills, Kemp. So today on our guided walk, we are going to bring something very, very interesting about the termites, okay? Why do termites build the mound? So a mound is something very big, like what's behind me right here. So, you know, termites, they live in social structures, you know, social societies, which we call them the colonies. So a colony lives inside the mound. A colony may consist about 1.5 to 2 million of termites living within there. And these guys, they all communicate through vibrations and touch. So inside the colony, we have three divisions. The first divisions are the soldiers, and the second divisions are the workers, and the third divisions are the reproductives. So the soldiers are always there to protect the mound from invaders. They have this kind of big mandibles, okay? If you try to put your hands inside there, they're gonna bite you vigorously because you're disturbing them, obviously. And the second divisions, which are are the workers are always there to be building the mound. So if you find a very freestanding mound and very good looking mound, that is because of the workers. How their work is just to repair the mound every time the mound collapses in some way or another. You know, you get these big animals like elephants or buffaloes who try to come and try, you know, scratch themselves if they feel itchy. So they'll try scratch themselves over here, and by doing that, they are going to remove some part of this mound, and the workers will sense that with that immediate effect. You know, they're like pre-programmed to do something very, very quickly after sensing it. So if they sense that, they'll come and start sealing the mound and rebuild it again. And the reproductives are inside there. There's a certain chamber where there is a queen and a king, okay? The queen, she's an egg-laying machine. So in a day, she lays so many eggs. And her work is just to stay there and produce the eggs as much as she can. The workers will always be there to feed her, to clean her. She doesn't really move, and she grows in about 6 centimeters with this kind of creamy, sluggish body. But with that, still the same size of the termite heads. So she lays so many eggs, about 30,000 eggs per day, okay? And the eggs are being transported from where she is to another chamber by these workers. So you can see workers are doing quite a lot of stuff down inside the mound. And if you calculate the amount of eggs she lays in a day in, you know, like 1 year, that would be about 10 millions of eggs. 10 millions of eggs, that's quite incredible. Her lifespan is about 15 years. So if you calculate that again, it's going to be some incredible big number of eggs, about 164 millions of eggs that she lays in her lifetime. So you wonder, I wonder how Mother's Day is like inside the colony. It's going to be quite incredible. So why do termites really build the mound? You know, it's their home, obviously, but we have different species of termites that they don't really build the mound. But these mound building termites, they have a specific reason to do that. They are facing, you know, an environmental challenge, which is, you know, they cannot really digest the cellulose. So without digesting the cellulose, they have to overcome it. How? Is that they cannot really eat something and that something won't be digested. So they have to be doing something else that we cannot really see that in our outside world. So termites are farmers. They farm a specific genus of fungus, which we call it the termitomyces, okay, which is at the base right there of the mound. So the termitomyces, this fungus, helps them to digest this kind of wood materials, which when they come outside through different tunnels, they pick some wood materials, dead plant materials, and they take that to the fungus. So the fungus helps them to break down this cellulose into more digestible and nutritional food for the termites. So the termites will be eating the fungus and not the grasses or any kind of wood materials. That's why they build the mound, okay? Just because they are farming that fungus. So they eat nothing else apart from the fungus, okay? And this termitomyces is not found anywhere else in the world than inside the termite mounds. So I thought I could just bring that to you. You know, it's quite interesting that we don't really see things sometimes, but we can just see how these guys are doing a great job on building this, but we we cannot really definitely tell why do they do that, okay? So it's quite an incredible stuff for me. And of course, with building like this as an ecosystem, you have to do something and help others. You know, if the termites are not around anymore, or sometimes even if they're there, these kind of holes, they may, you know, serve big, big homes for snakes, I mean, mongooses. You know, you have these kind of bat-eared foxes, they use the termite mounds as their home. So thank you very much, and thank you for your attention and listening. Hopefully we're going to catch up again on our next episode of our guided walk up here in the northern part of the Serengeti. And this is Steven again, all the way from Limala Kuril's camp. Hey guys, I'm still out here. May I come in?